Hi everybody, pleased to meet you. I am so Rick and be sitting with you. My name is Federico Destavola and I'm a PhD student at Mexico National University. I thank Mattia, Maurilio, Nicolò and all who participate in the organization of this roundtable. Thank you very much for the invitation. At the moment, I'm researching on a Colombian platform named Rappi, which operates mostly but not exclusively in the sector of food delivery. Along with the classic service of food delivery common to platforms such as Uber Eats, Deliveroo and Just Eat, Rappi offers the service of common courier, cash delivery, and although it is not particularly used yet, the interesting service of providing small personal tasks such as walking the dog or pay the bill at the banks. Rappi, in these first 3 years as a startup, increased its financial value by $1 billion, gaining the title of Unicorn Enterprise. And it operates in the larger megalopolis of cities of Brazil, Mexico, Argentina, Chile, Peru, Colombia, Uruguay. I will take the interview that I will read in one moment as an example because Mr. Ruales, Commercial Director of Rappi, in this brief description clearly demonstrates the ideological elements and real Mexican phenomena with which and on which the platform are installed. Rappi was born approximately 3 years ago with a deep understanding of a reality of Latin America. So what we found was a very nice possibility as a company to create a platform that will connect these two group population group. A group that has certain income but unfortunately does not have much time. And a population group also quite important that has little time available, is bigger than the first group, but unfortunately does not have enough time for buzzing things. Now briefly analyze. First, on the ideological level, the company is certainly positioned as a super partners connector between two undetermined subjects. Second, work is as abstracted, transformed into time, provision and social classes cheapen when they are transformed into population group. Finally, it recognizes the great disparity and polarization of class as social economical environment in which the platform is installed and as a fundamental condition for the entrepreneurship. Rappi model is not very different from that of the other entities technique search called austere platform. Some common features are the extreme and total outsourcing on one end, and on the other, the absolute save in labor workforce cost. Due to the implementation of peaceful wage and labor relation characterized by a misleading autonomy. From a theoretical point of view, we can state the rapid display in a certain way the axiomatic capacity of capital that is tendency to adapt and create isomorphic forms by crushing with the specific condition it finds when it hits the ground. This has important consequences, not only on the very forms of its operation, but also in terms of production of subjectivity. With the notion of operation of capital, I refer to the last work of Sandro Mezzadre and Brett Nielsen, The Politics of Operation, which focuses on the dimension of finance, logistics, and extraction within contemporary capitalism. By considering their approach, we can analyze how the food delivery platform act are quite emblematic site of articulation of financial, logistical, and extractive operation. For example, for the tendency to nurture in financial bubbles, for their function as urban logistic platform, and for their data mining activities that compel the very logic of abstraction and subsume and capture the rider subjectivity. Extraction, logistic, and finance function are logics that intimately inform the platform. In order to analyze some of Rappi's specific features in territorial context of Mexico City, which is the case of study I'm researching in my PhD actually, I propose a theoretical concept that will lead my argument and let me identify some dynamics that such platforms find at the day hitting the ground in Mexican megalopolis urban fabric. I refer to the so-called neoliberalism from below, a notion proposed by Argentine anthropologist Veronica Gago. Gago's concept considered neoliberalism from a Foucaultian point of view as a form of governing through the stimulation of freedoms. Such an apparent contradiction tell as much of particularity on the particularity of platform works narratives. The promotion of wider degrees of autonomy, for example, by giving the possibility to log in during the time the worker prefers, but at the same time, to the extreme precariousness, the governmentality of responsibility of adapting the work activity to the vital needs, to the vital and the market needs. Continuing shortly on Gago's concept, it has another implication related to the work in platform. As we know, the platform outsources some means of production to the riders, such as the bike and the telephone. The neoliberalism from below, specifically in the informal sector, encouraged the mobilization of communal, familiar and popular means to create a total self-entrepreneurship popular experience. In this way, the platform, when it hit the ground in Mexico City context, find some fertile subject and reign. The outsourcing of means of production and the same entrepreneurial rationality, which implicates the capacity of organizing the reproduction of labor force in situation of high precariousness in wage and a composition of the latter made by many very low incomes, are common features in the metropolis life. In consequence, the subjectivity produced by the work in platform subsumes these subjectivity characteristics of the informal sector. At the same time, the situation displays difference with the same in a European context. In Mexico City, the wage of labor condition in platform's work are not significantly different from those of the main part of Mexican labor force. Indeed, more than 46.1% of the human labor force work in a situation of informality, which means that don't have access to the basic service such as healthcare, retirement benefit, or paid vacation days. As it's obvious, INRAPI is the same, since the workers are not recognized as employed, but as autonomous workers. On the other side, the precarious and fluctuating wage is sufficiently high to consider that the rider in Mexico gain as much as, or in some case more of, the 59% of the working population. In the words of Simon Borrero, one of the founder of and current CEO of RAPI, in Latin America, differently from Europe, the public opinion is less critical to the platform since they guarantee acceptable levels of wage. As we saw, the wage paid by RAPI is not very different from the average wage, but it doesn't mean a difference in company's ethics. It is rather the consequence of extreme polarization of wage and consumption in Latin America, which implies the very side of access to consumption are dramatically different between the lower class and the middle upper one. Under this condition, the cost of the selfie results acceptable for the middle and upper class, who pay high cost for this consumption, while the wage, or the acceptable misery, paid to the rider is sufficient for the consumption sphere of the lower class. Another factor that is necessary to mention to pass to explain the rise of Mexican rider organization is the corrupt and bad reputation that the union have in the country. The Mexican industrial relations system is characterized by a strong alliance between the government, the capital, and the corrupt unions. This has made researchers speak of a lack of union democracy. Not accidentally, indeed, some of the most intense and interesting Mexican workers' struggles shape emerged in the recent years precisely against the corrupt unions. During the last 6 months, two very different riders organizations were born in Mexico City. The first began to organize around the problem of danger in viability. I say viability and not danger in work because this group refused to self-present as a collective of workers, rather preferring to associate to the identity of cyclists. Its name is New Repartidor Menos, and it protests in occasion of riders' accident and deaths, are demands and look out for a reformulation of the cultural street attitude. The participation that they is able to generate only through WhatsApp and Facebook with memes, collectives, chats and dedicated social network pages is impressive. However, this strength is at the same time a limit because New Repartidor Menos has not really organized a moment of real and face-to-face meeting. The only moments of street assembly are in occasion of manifestation of anger for eventual death of some riders. The other organization that was born in the wake of this extraordinary expansion of platform is a union with a strong propensity for the legal field. The UP Riders Union, CIRA, has until now maintained an anti-confrontational position toward the companies, without neither demanding social insurance and preferring contracting private one to guarantee medical care to the affiliated riders. Even through the difficulties mentioned, the class fraction of the riders in Mexico has spontaneously affirmed its existence against the digital platform narratives that pretends, according to the logistical rationality, the smooth space in social and labor relation through the subsumption of work into self-entrepreneurship. Now I finish, and I thanks another time very much to all. Goodbye, thank you very much.